When we consider the greatest and most stunning archaeological uncovering in the history of the discovery of the past, the Terracotta Warriors spring to mind as the most significant find of all time. So it was hardly surprising to find out that they have just uncovered another 220 soldiers at the world-famous Mausoleum of the Emperor, which, by the way, the warrior soldiers are only part of the massive unexcavated complex. Back in 2009, one of the biggest archaeological digs on the planet commenced, the third excavation of the number one pit of the warrior figures began, with an excavation area of 200 meters squared. Up to now, this round of excavation in the number one pit has unearthed 114 figures in total, with the latest 220 warrior figures making a total of 334 warrior figures at this one dig. The warriors showed vivid facial expressions and postures, various types of appearances with different features for their costumes, hairstyles, and weapons. However, the warrior figures in the number one pit were a bit too tall, ranging from 1.8 meters to 2 meters, which made conservation difficult, and they were all damaged. The figures unearthed include 28 armored footmen figures lined up in 6 rows and 6 chariot officer figures in 2 groups. The warrior figures unearthed this time showed obvious burning stains. They might have been burnt by the rebels of the peasant uprising in the late years of the dynasty. Between the years of 1974 and 1977, the world watched in disbelief as the ancient faces began to see the light of day for the first time in 2 millennia. Discovered in 1974 when local farmers were digging out a well in a field, accidentally discovering the life-size army of Emperor Qin. Since then, an underground army, which has remained buried for over 2,000 years, has been unearthed, and a museum was built at the site. There are many other archaeological digs in and around this pit, Pit 2 and 3 being major archaeological digs on the location, with this Pit 1 being the biggest one and the site of the latest 220 life-sized figurines. The excitement just keeps building, with scientists using remote sensing, ground-penetrating radar, and core sampling have also revealed the Emperor's tomb complex to be much larger than once believed. This site is thought to be an eye-watering almost 38 square miles, suggesting the magnitude of this complex has been seriously overlooked until now. At its heart, a tall earthen mound that covers the ruler's tomb, which remains sealed. Many other people were also buried at the site. Archaeologists have discovered mass graves that appear to hold the remains of the craftsmen and laborers, including convicted criminals in chains, who died during the 3 decades it took to create the royal mausoleum. Other mass burials seem to tell grisly tales of a brutal struggle to capture the emperor's throne. Despite the brilliance and power of the first emperor, he was unable to make sure his eldest son succeeded him. It was a failure that had devastating consequences. Experts now believe it may have launched a bloodbath and ultimately brought a swift end to the dynasty that he had founded. An account written in about 89 BC by an official in the Second Dynasty describes a time of deadly palace intrigue. One of the emperor's many sons conspired with the chief eunuch to murder his oldest brother, the emperor's presumed heir, and to seize the throne himself, and to back up the grisly document, archaeologists have found tantalizing clues that the power grab was even more brutal than described. A group of skeletons was found with artifacts belonging to the royal family. These were mostly males, possibly the deceased emperor's sons. One skull offers clues to their fate. It's split by the metal bolt from a crossbow, likely shot at close range. Experts now believe these young princesses may have been executed by their ambitious sibling who was trying to secure the throne for himself. The site at the Pit 1 is absolutely littered with artifacts from this era. It is riddled with pottery, bronze, jade, a small amount of gold, silver, and iron, and the well-preserved artifacts, including military tripods, crossbows, golden sabers, and everyday items such as spoons. The researchers also discovered the earliest known golden camel excavated in China, with further study of this artifact in particular that may provide important information about trade between the West and the Chinese emperor predating the Silk Road. Among the 220 new figures discovered, there is the discovery of new officer ranks that may force a rethink of our current understanding of this army's formation, as well as a large number of weapons and archaeological relics belonging to previously unseen military officers nestled among the ranks. It has been suggested that the Greeks came to China to design these warriors. Researchers also believe the sudden appearance of life-sized statues in China around this time point to a presence of Greek artists who would have brought their sculpting techniques to the East following Alexander the Great's reign. Prior to this, Chinese statues were typically no taller than 20 centimeters. This is all from us for the moment, guys. 220 life-size figurine warrior soldiers discovered that were previously unknown at the Pit 1 of the archaeological dig of the Terracotta Army in China. But what do you guys think about this anyway? Comments below, and as always, thank you for watching.